I started this passionately after I got married, but actually I come from a home where embroidery, needlework, art was all part of the family's heritage. So my mom was a very, very good needlewoman, and we grew up in a home, although we were not rich at all, we just had very cheap fabrics, actually, China cotton and things like that. But mummy would always embroider, she would add some laces, and all our dresses were envied by so many of the other girls. And mummy was always very strict about us girls, my sister and me, learning some kind of sewing. As a little girl at the age of 7, 8, I already started embroidering handkerchiefs, started embroidering table runners and crochet, and even tatting. Tatting was considered to be a very difficult art. And we are so proud that our nephew Anurendra has now taken after his grandmother, and so it runs in our family where we all carry a little bit of creativity and artistic talents. So I got busy with studying and, you know, obtaining my degrees and things like that. Then I got married, and I married a professor who was completely buried in his books and always doing his research and writings. And I had three boys of my own. I taught in a completely boys' school, and these boys actually sapped the energy out of me during the day. So when I came home at night, I just had to find something that would be relaxing and not drain my brains, you know. With years gone by and Prof and I settling into a routine life where after work he comes home and he does his own writing and research, and I'm just close by knitting or sewing or quilting, and the day goes by, you know. There was a story behind his quilt of right from the time he was born to becoming a young man playing football. You know, a lot of the pictures are him playing football, his university days. So I picked out all those pictures of him, and then of his married life with me and the children, you know, many pictures with his children and him. And then it gradually came down when he became sick. I did take a bit of pictures, not that I like to do it, but I did take a little bit of pictures, nice pictures of him on the hospital bed reading and things like that. And finally, of course, when we lost him. The whole idea of that quilt came about when, after he passed away, we had so many messages from all people of all walks of life. That was what touched our hearts. It was very painful, actually. I cried a lot while I was doing the quilt, but it turned out to be really beautiful. And now with it's hanging in the sitting room, and we always feel he's around us. No race, no religion, everyone was a friend to him. So that was the story behind that quilt. Well, now that he's gone, it's a big vacuum in my life because he's been there with me for 55 years, actually. Now I do a lot of reading, and I do a lot of quilting, a lot of sewing, you know. So the day passes by very, very fast. And I'm at home most of the time, but I don't feel bored, you know, I don't feel bored at all. So it's a very, very good therapy for someone who is lonely. Actually, I'm quite lonely now without Prof, but it keeps me very, very busy. And that's how I spend my days.